team started out this season with singular goals, to make it to the NCAA tournament. Dick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the East Tennessee State Bucks and the Iowa Hawkeyes.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Hawkeyes should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Dick, as they're highly favored on paper. But what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. Number one, make good decisions with the rock. Don't turn it over, baby. Second, don't let your man beat you to the rebound. And lastly, be aggressive defensively and force the offense out of its rhythm.
Well, Dick, let's get down to the court and let's get the action underway. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
For the bucket. Doesn't go.
Pushing that basketball.
The turn and fadeaway jumper.
I tell you, uses the ball really well, too. In terms of putting it to the depth, turns, spins. He's got every move in the book.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Here's a double team. Perfectly executed. They look to get it to the inside. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. From the top of the circle, they are red hot right now.
They're feeling it from everybody on the floor, Brad. They're getting it from every spot on the court.
Count's getting high.
Look at that spacing.
Working it around the perimeter, trying to feed inside. Number two fakes the shot. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Number 11. Modest play is having a negative effect on his composure. Emotionally, he couldn't be much lower, I don't think.
Well, he knows he's not getting it done, and emotionally, it's bringing him down.
Dumps it in. Turns it over. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Looking for a good shot. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. On the outside, way out on top, controlling the ball. Number 53 makes a great move to draw the foul. He goes to the line for the first time. First one, good. Got them both.
Oh, he drained it. That's him a nylon, NBA.
To feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside. Shooter spotting up on a three.
Way off target. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Had him in the post and didn't pass it in. Reverses it.
There's the screen up on top.
Puts it up looking for contact.
To get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
They'll work it around the arc. And the ball goes out of play. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort. trying to go inside.
The center takes the feed.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man. I want to see that again.
Number 40 gets the ball. Number 52 is whistled for the foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, with the score so close, both teams seem so intense on their benches right now. Both coaches have told me it all comes down to turnovers and miscues.
All right, thanks, Aaron. And he got them both.
Double team now, bad angle. What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. There's a bad pass right to the defender.
The ball goes out play.
Coming inside.
Number two takes the pass. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. They don't seem to be getting any decent shot opportunities, Dick.
Because they're looking in the wrong places, Brad.
Dick, he's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I think doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
The center gets the pass. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you, they did a great job scouting post play.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot. That was a great, great effort right there, trying to play that passing lane. Anticipating really well. Run him right into the screen again. What did I say?
From left of the circle.
Hey, one basket, Brad. If they can get some points here, the crowd will be extremely happy.
The shooting guard with the ball. Now the high screen blocks it. Looking for a good shot. They've left him completely alone. They work it around the perimeter. He shoots.
Great job of running the defender into the screen for the nice J.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. And in and out.
A defensive stop will definitely get the fans out of their seats.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He looks at the hoop.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Number three is fired up right now, emotional.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Working it around the perimeter. Foul charge. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He goes to the line. It's good. East Tennessee State are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now. There's the trap.
Number 23 steals the ball.
Oh, what a great job transition. Offense. Poor job defensively. Don't get back. Don't stop the ball. And they're allowed to convert. Get the number game going.
wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. He takes the shot from the baseline. Tickles a twine. Picks off the lazy pass. The crowd loves this young man.
The people here really appreciate what he brings to the table.
He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know he's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
Got some room for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
He's going to muscle it on the inside.
What an explosive move to the goal. No wasted time. He had his mind made up and was attacking the basket. Defense! Defense! Defense!
Defense! Tries for two. Perfectly executed. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
From the top of the key, way off target. Nice shot.
Brad, if they were smart, they'd go 2-for-1.
Up fake. Jump hook from the low post. Can't get the shot to drop.
Look at that spacing.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Drops the bucket despite the harm. Number 52 is asking the fans for even more encouragement.
Brad, he wants some fan support for this offensive possession. Great execution. That's offensive efficiency at its best.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, you're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter.
Great play to take that to the basket.
The ball goes out of bounds. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
In the dying moments, misses on the jumper from three. At the half, the Bucks are up by four. Worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turn it over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Well, let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin. There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Here's the offensive drop step in the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Doesn't go. They'll work it around the arc for two. They still don't score.
that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Try to come up with a steal, and they do. Jumps in. Basket falls despite the contact. Gave it up. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
He fakes the shot. Gets it back out.
Dick, they're doing a great job defensively down there in the low block.
I tell you, what a great job on a defensive player. He's winning the battle on the interior because he's beating him to the spot.
On the dribble, gives it up with the fake. Fakes it. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Rims out. Gave it up. Now they work it around the perimeter. For two. Was that beautiful or what?
Let's slow this one down on a replay.
On the outside, the shooting guard handles the pass.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
The center receives the ball. From the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. Goes up for two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic. You better get rid of it, Brad.
Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing. He's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Gave it up. Picked out of the air. From the top of the key. Off the rim and no good. They work the perimeter. It's stolen. Turnover. Great job knocking the ball loose, then chasing it down. He gives him the fake. Got a nice screen. Good job defensively.
Look at that spacing.
Tough spot defensively in the post, but he got the steal.
Wow, I could have made that steal. He telegraphed that. He was the Marconi guy. What a poor pass.
East Tennessee State have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
Kicks it out. Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For the deuce. Can't get the shot to go. Picked off. The shooting guard receives the pass. Moving it around the perimeter. Got the high pick. From beyond the arc. And the ball goes out of play. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
intercepts it. Here's the offensive drop step and the low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. He drains it.
Nice fake.
There's a double team waiting there. Gets the ball and out faces his man down in the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
East Tennessee State are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can force a timeout.
And a momentary look from three-point land. The Hawkeyes have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
He can't get the bucket to fall. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it'll come down to in this game.
Picks off the lazy pass. The power forward handles the feed. Steal. Tries for two. And in and out. They're working around the perimeter. In the paint. For the bucket. Contact causes the shot to come off. He draws a foul as we take a look here at our backcourt production.
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. Productivity from the backcourt is a must. You must initiate the offense, distribute the ball, and score. These are all things that you rely on your backcourt to do.
First one, good. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
He makes the third shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
From left of the circle, he hits it. What I call a hard screen. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. Kicks it out. Tenn on the shot clock. They're working around the perimeter. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
East Tennessee State are doing a nice job of pulling a solid run together here.
Hey, they're really starting to click on offense.
Something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
One on the shot clock. Cross court. Intercepted.
Up and inside.
Has a nice look at the basket. Goes out of play. No. They'll work it around the arc. Great defense. Working it around the perimeter. He fires from long range. He couldn't get it to fall. Jumped in front to take it away. He takes the three. Rims out. On the dribble, gives it up. Number 44 steals the ball. Goes up for two. He's money with a shot. Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Bucks is off to a strong start with an opening round victory here.
Hey, keeping the momentum will be crucial as they have one day off before they head back to the hardwood for their second round game.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.